Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, this is Best in Slot, and in tonight's video, we are going to start a brand new creative park build right here in Jurassic World Evolution. Still not sure what the park is going to be called, but it's essentially the No Dinosaur Park. Every animal in here will be a prehistoric creature that isn't a dinosaur. I think we're going to go with Pleistocene. A lot of them are Pleistocene creatures, but there's a couple of exceptions. We'll say they're special guests or something. Now, we are using a bunch of mods here. Two most important ones, of course, are the Expanded Map mod by, Expanded Islands, I should call it, by Toho Society, and the Enhanced Terrain Tools by Harlequin's Ego. That's going to give us all this space. If we want to build over here for the first time ever, we can build over here for the first time ever. We can do whatever we like in the confines of this humongous map area. The world is our oyster. I'll very quickly go through the other mods we're using for today. We're using the tundra environment that you can see here. That's made by Dan Murphy 1014. You know, give it a bit of an Ice Age kind of vibe. We have some custom fences, which I've highlighted on the channel before, but they're very, very cool. Look at them. Big chunky boys. These are by Mr. Troodon. And I also have a custom path mod, which I've never used before, by the Dandyman. And apparently, yeah, it's going to give us these really cool modern paths, as you can see. Really, really nice looking. Look at that, isn't that great? Yeah, good stuff. Also on top of that, we're going to use one creature today, which is a Leptobus, a creature I haven't showcased on the channel before. It's like an extinct large bison-esque creature, and that's made by Sayaka, who has done many of the prehistoric creatures we've showcased in the past. Now, no. So I want to mess around with the terrain tools, right? So we're going to do some mountains and stuff like that, but I really want to do, like, a pit. So what we're going to do, we're going to kick things off right away with a monorail station. Like so. And let's just connect those together. You arrive and you're shipped off nice and quick, okay? And then we're going to do, like, a... You know, we always have, like, a hatchery area and, you know, you've got your ranger team, blah, 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 blah. We need that area in the park, so... I'm just trying to get them down, basically. Like, just get them built, and we'll go from there on a basic level. There we go. And we can mess around with our new paths. I think we want to use... I'm going to use the wood for the guests, because it's fancy. And my guests are fancy people, of course. So my concern is, I wanted to do, like, islands, like, nearly floating islands, and having the exhibits on these islands. The problem is, I don't know how the ranger team... would ever get there to refill the feeders, and I believe... Let me have a little look. Do we have infinite feeders? Is that actually a thing? Because I can't remember. We do! Sweet! I don't have to worry about that at all. Alright, cool. So we can do that. So what we're going to do is we're going to have a big old pit. Pit! And that's the idea. This is like a... You know, it's a staff area. It's off to the side. It isn't for public access. So, you know, pit. Basically. Just to emphasize that as much as possible. There you go, you're not allowed over there. Staff. Staff only. Instead of a staff only sign, like most people, we have pit. And the pit does the same job. There we go. Pit. And we'll have to do the monorail going over there, but that's okay. Come on, you. Okay, so technically, they do go over there because they go on the monorail, but... Shut up. Basically. Why aren't you being weird? Don't know. Anyways, a little bit... we're going to kind of curve alongside the pit. I think that's cooler. Like so. And then we land over here. And we just need to try to get one of these in without it breaking. Looks like... Because I kind of want... Obviously, the track has to come past as well. So we're going to delete just a little bit here. Or loads, as that case may be. Bring it back around. There we go. Lovely stuff. Right, sweet. Pit. And we'll put... Well, just in case people decide they want to die, Oh, nice. We can do that. We'll connect a fence across here as well. Just to block the pit off. As much as realistically possible. There we go. Very cool. Very cool. Makes the camera go a bit funky, but... And if we do this, you know, maybe it'll look okay. Get rid of some of the trees on the side. It looks like a quarry, doesn't it? It's got that kind of feel to it. We can make this maybe a little bit more natural looking by just... lowering certain parts of it, basically. If you make it not all the same height, yeah, that looks better already. Fell in the pit. There we go. We have a pit now. Unfortunately, I've completely forgotten what dinosaur Leptopus replaces, so I have to go check. It is Pentaceratops. How do you not? Oh, right. Now I need to remember this. What is it that makes it not have a path connection? Is it just because it's an incomplete track? I don't think so. I'm just gonna cut this up for a second, but I don't think this is it. I think it needs like a shop or something, right? To be designated as a working monorail. I don't really know why that's the case, but that was completely wrong. Okay, sweet. So we're looking for a Pentaceratops. And I say we're looking for one, we're looking for many. I believe, if I had to guess, all of these are going to look approximately the same. But we'll knock out a bunch of different colours anyway, just in case. And see what the happy haps are. Definitely want Alpine. We'll just pick four that we think could be appropriate. I think they are all going to look the same. Woodland's okay. Woodland Step sounds like a plan. Is that a cheeky little coastal at the bottom? It's a cheeky little coastal. One of the reasons I picked Sanctuary as the map, because it's not the biggest or the most exciting to flatten, is because we have this beautiful snow-drenched beach, and I also have the Mosasaurus mod. Now, obviously, that's going to be a future video, but we're actually going to build a pen inside the water and hopefully have the Mosasaurus swimming around underwater. We've always had a really cool Mosasaurus mod, but it floated above the ground because it was essentially a Spinosaurus. So if we sink it into the water, it's going to look like an actual Mosasaurus. It's going to be amazing. I'm very excited about this. anyways, yeah, so that will be changed later on, but it'll do for now. So what I was thinking is I kind of want to put this on a pit as well. I like pits. Okay, I've decided. Pits are my thing. So we're going to go down. And I'd like one of these. So the idea is to sort of separate the habitats and stuff, fire this series of monorail stops in these big, deep pits. And the exciting thing about this is something we literally just couldn't have done in the past, right? We couldn't do this before. This wasn't possible at all. But also, I really want to build like a habitat down here in the pit. I think that'd be really cool as well. Have the monorail drop you down there, and you'll have something down there at some point. I'm not sure which of the creatures. Maybe the terror birds, you know, emphasize that kind of spooky kind of feeling. That might be pretty cool. It reminds me of building Planet Zoo. We actually just got so much sudden creativity that it feels like Planet Zoo all of a sudden. It's kind of crazy. You can imagine it like a like the tectonic plates are shifting. It's the Ice Age, the world is an upheaval, and underneath all of it, the tectonic plates are going ga-ga-ga-ga-ga-ga. You know? That's the official term. Side note, I think this is a much quicker way of doing this. I think if we grab our water brush, we can do this. Yes, look at that! And then we get rid of the water. That's a much better way of flattening things. Oh, very cool. Right, we're going to go right up to the edge of the pit, I think. Oh, too much. I love that. It looks like a dam. That's very cool. Damn, that's cool. Sorry. Right, anyways. Easy does it, girl. Easy does it. And we can obviously make these mountains a little bit less shock. Which is the official term, by the way. But we can use this to carve out in like a really cool way. I really like it. I think it's going to look awesome. Or it's going to look abysmal. Can't tell. Right. So we're just going to have our initial exhibit right here at the front. You know, this is the first episode, inaugural episode. We've had to do some setup and stuff like that. So for the purposes of getting a blimmin' move on, I'm just going to carve out an island here in the middle. That's a little bit on the small side, I think we can say. The problem is, you do this, and it's fine, but then if you screw up like I just did, then you have to go back to slow mode. I suppose it's not that bad. We can even edge out the sides a little bit, just give it a little bit more of a natural sort of bulky shape to it. You know, it's not as straight-edged as it was. It's a bit curvy, it's a bit juicy. That's a really nice shape. You could even knock in some of the edges a little bit, flatten there maybe, just Give it a little bit of character, you know? Maybe a bit of a rim. I think that looks really good. I mean, that looks really, really good. I don't know if it's big enough, because we are going to have to build an exhibit and a monorail station and stuff like that, but we shall see. Now, let's journey back to the pit and meet our Pentaceratops / Leptobus. So, reminder, this is made by Sayaka. I'm going to make a Google document with all the mods in this playlist, because there's like 11, and every single mod will be linked in one big document, so you guys can check it out. Let's meet this big old prehistoric bull. That's pretty awesome. It's got a big old neck, boy. Well, that is actually not the default color on the look at it from the. I mean, up close, it's a little bit funky. Does that have evil eyes? Sakura's creatures always have evil eyes. Let's check it out. Can you get in the light, please? I see evil red eyes. Does that count? I gotta say, the eyes are pretty nice. I mean, they are evil. It's got that kind of look that you'd expect from, you know, like the goat in The Witch, or the Witch, if you want to do it like that, but whatever. Hey, it looks really good there, though. Ooh, that tree. Ooh, you're a baddie bee. A baddie bee tree. Now, as per usual, I will do a, it's called a, what is it called? It's so long since we've done this. There's a website I use where you can sign up. You do have to sign up. But then you can submit names for certain dinosaurs. I guess it's going to be a bit awkward for this series, so what I'm going to do is make a tag for each different species. So what you do is I'll link it down below. I cannot remember what. It's called Quanti or something like that. I'll link that website down below. You click that website, you go on it, you sign up, and then there will be a category for Leptobus. And there you submit your names, and then next video, I will bring in your name suggestions onto our creatures. Are they all going to be this color? The ones in the Nexus mods were, like, black. But these are all the same. This looks better. It must be said, the black one was a little bit... That's a hell of a neck, isn't it? You can see how the... It's the kind of, you know, that ceratopsid animation cycle that's doing it. They look great, though. Last one, Coastal, you're my only hope. This is pretty cool, too. Setting additional tasks. Oh, two? Two tasks? How do I upgrade this? Oh, I clicked the wrong thing, that's why. Scheduling. Still unsure which word I say. You have anything like that where someone asks you, do you say schedule or schedule? And you don't know the answer. Somehow, you yourself do not know what you say. I couldn't tell you which one I tend to go for. I have no idea what my preference is out of those two. Which is a little bit bizarre in my opinion. But hey ho. I'm excited about this. This is going to be awesome. Got some pretty cool ideas for future builds as well. This is just the first one that came to mind, really. Like I said, we'll replace the monorail at some point, so I'm not going to worry too much about that. We'll have to do it a little bit now. Let's shoot the others in the face. Confirmed. Did they all end up looking the same? I think so. Kind of grey with this slight red underbelly to them. Now, they're going to die, so we need to get to work, basically. And what I want to do as well is bring this back across slightly. Just so the fence, if we can make the fence look like it ends, like against a wall, you know? Close enough. Right, so, let's sort the monorail out. Just temporarily. Sure, it didn't need a full track, you know. I'm kind of confused by this. It has been a very long time since I built a park, though. There's every chance that I'm completely wrong. You're gonna be a bit awkward, aren't you, buddy? What do you possibly need to flatten? Just work. Like, what do you need from me? Okay. Alternate plan. We go there. Alright, we need to try to drop this a little bit more naturally down the hill. So it's not great. There we go. Look at that. Yes. It's always gonna. I think if we did it more gradually, we could probably get rid of that. But I don't think that's a big deal either. Right. Okay, let me think. As dangerous as that sounds, what do we want to use for a wall? What have we got here? That's okay, but you can't see through it, which is silly. Maybe that one. Honestly, that's like the Indominus paddock. That's very cool. We might use that as like a supporting structure. I think this one's the right one. The electrified heavy steel. That feels good. Oh, we can do like, look, they're like little jumping things, hurdles for the Leptobus. So we can do some, you know, activities. We'll have so much room for activities. Okay, cool. Right. Electrified. I'm just going to curl this as best we can around the outside. We're going to give them a we're going to make more of them and give them a nice big paddock, I think. At the end of the day, it's a bull. It's a bison-esque creature. It wants to roam. It wants to hunt. Sort of. I kind of want to get this bit in as well, this little dinky bit. I love me a dinky bit. Will you like the dinky bit? Let's find out. Have it curl behind the monorail slightly. And by slightly, I mean by bloody loads. I'm going to leave a little room just in case I need it for something else, but... because I just want to come in a bit here so we've got room for viewing areas and stuff like that. Okay, let's go for that. So the idea is really you'd only stop here for the Leptobus, and then you would, you know, hop back on the monorail and it would take you off to the next area. It looks like we've used a lot of room up. At the end of the day, we have all the room in the world, essentially. We have all the room we could possibly want, which is very cool. Whoops. Right, okay, let's get these shipped over before something goes terribly wrong. This is the only problem with the pit. The pit wants to absorb me. The void is calling to me. Every time I move past, it's like, nom 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 nom, come here, best in slot. Nom 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 nom. That's what pits sound like, by the way, in case you were curious. In case you were wondering, I'm going to show you how. Right, we can't just have them. I want to give them like a fairly open area because they are, you know, it's a free roaming kind of creature. However, we can't just give them nothing. Let's put in a viewing area. I'm gonna put two. Ooh, can I put one there? If I get rid of this. Let's find out. Bit cheeky, that one, innit? Bit cheeky. I'll put something else there. We'll do other areas that are a bit more normal park build, you know? But. A fun start, I think. Oh. Awkward. There's a way to do this, and I cannot for the life. Let me just do that. There we go. Very cool. You're saying you're not. Oh, yeah. Bear with me. And flatten a little bit here. Actually, no, even less. Even less. I want this. No, I gotta think about this. Okay, yeah, I've got it. Basically, just what I said. Now, my concern was they can't get from here to here, but what we'll do. Is then this. We'll just make a little step area here. So they have to cross through the water and coal to get across, but that's okay. That's cool. I mean, that alone is awesome, honestly. It's just so... I don't know. I'm excited. Can you tell? I know it's hard to tell. We might do a little bit more like this in a little bit. Let's get some rocks in here. We should have nice tundra-esque rocks. There they are. Wow, these guys cannot handle the hill, can they? What is going on with you, buddy boy? Gone a little bit mad. Okay, so this is going to be more like the open... Wow, it does struggle a little bit with the flattening, as you can tell. It's not taking to it that well. That's okay. I'll put some trees over here instead. Oh, Also like Planet Zoo, in that if you don't hammer the trees, they don't actually go down. I don't want to block that area off too much, but between those two, that's good. Nice open area there. And we'll put the feeder over here as well, since this is our viewing area. Yeah, okay. Yeah, you can't really go anywhere near the edge. I think the game kind of still... This is a shot in the dark as to what's happening here. But if I had to guess... Although we have this nice sharp hill, which we wouldn't usually get. If you imagine we usually had this, the slope would be more like here. So maybe the game is still registering the usual slope, essentially. Look at that, though. So basically, they have to go in the area that would usually be provided, not the area that the mod provides, if that makes any sense. It may not. I may be talking absolute nonsense. Very possible, but who knows? I'm going to do a little bit more water over here, but up at the top, I think. Can we put a little shop in? Cheeky little... If I was here, what I would want an arcade. Of course. I don't think it's going to fit, though. No, we are playing with some limitations. What we can do... Big tree? No. I think hiccups. Little tree? Yep, okay. Hiccups, be gone. What we can do... is make a thing. We need our little fence, because this is like a display fence, you know? It's like... It keeps people out, but not in like a spooky way. In a sexy way. Yeah, look at that, that's a nice little circle I just made. It's a little bit lopsided, but who isn't these days? Okay, we want like a little bit of water in there. Not in the middle, so I don't know how that's gonna possibly work. It's not. Where's my tree gone? There it is. Oh. Yeah, okay, it's not really much of anything, I accept that, but... We're learning, guys. We're getting used to... Oh, maybe. Oh, so close to glory as well. So close. We've got even smaller. Come on. Yes, get in there, you cheeky little blighter. Get in there. Alright, cool. Bring that back in. I don't know, it's just a thing, you know? It's a thing. Deal with it. Yeah. It is what it is. We could even put that fence. I think it'd be really well suited to, like... How close can I get there? Like, just going along there. It's the kind of fence you would have in a park, and we don't have to use big, terrifying ones. We can use little baby ones. It's a great mod, honestly. We should stop doing that, though. Every bloody fence in the bloody game does this. There we go. Leave that bit a bit open. Easy does it. Easy does it, girl. Perfect. Nice. Very cool. Very cool. Right. I think we need more trees and stuff. Oh, we also need some snow. This looks like snow. This is not snow. This is actually the grass. The snow. The sand, I mean. But the snow... It's snow. It's proper snow. So this is their, like, running snowy track area. And then we'll dash it around here and there. And I think we need some rock, because we lack variety of texture, I would suggest. Definitely on the mountain bits over here. Maybe that'll look a little bit more interesting. Okay, maybe around the edge of the water. And the edge over there. Oopsie daisy. Oh, whatever. There we go. I'm gonna go two nuts on it, but yeah, I'm pretty happy with this. I'd like more rocks. I don't want too many here because this is, like I say, like a free roam area for them, but there we go. I really like that. I think that's awesome. I really like this. The pit makes me obnoxiously happy. I kind of want to make it deeper. Is that nuts? I mean, it's got to be a pit, you know? It's not a hole, it's a pit. Yeah. There we go. Proper pit. A proper, proper pit. Okay, so that is our Leptobus habitat. I think I'm going to bring in more of them. I'm going to pop out another 4 or 5. We're going to have maybe 10 or so of them. But basically, that means just leave as many names as you would like. God, they look so weird going up hills. Can you stop? Why are you all over here? I know there's water, but there's food over here. Is that not more important? Look, it's right there. You nerds. I can get another cheeky rock in here. Not right now, obviously. I kind of want a tree down here as well. Sorry, I keep thinking of things I want to add. I think a tree will look really nice down here. They are, of course, completely blocking it. Get out the way. I know it's too close to the dinosaur. I can't do anything about it. Right, I'm just going on for too long now. I want them to get off the bloody hill. They're obsessed with this hill. It's like the dinosaurs in JPOG where they migrate to the southwest for God knows what reason. And they do. It's a thing, honestly. The dinosaurs in JPOG migrate to the southwest portion of the map. It's very strange. I just want some nice pretty shots, that's all. Yeah, that's cool though. Leptobus. Exploring its... To stay away from that pit. Do I have to get rid of the pit just because they're stupid? Is that the rule now? Aww. Anyways, yeah, so I'm going to hatch, a bunch of these. If you want to leave name suggestions for them. Love that with the monorail going in the path in the distance. And the curve of the monorail here is really cool as well. If you want to leave name suggestions for them, you can do so down below in the QT. That's what it's called. In the QT. Do let me know. Don't let me know in the comment section. Do let me know in the QT. That's where I'll take the names from. We're going to go for 10, 11 of them or something like that. So just chuck the names in there and I'll pick tons of different ones out. What are you guys doing? And if you have any ideas for what you'd like to see in the next videos, what do we do with this park, feel free to let me know in the comment section down below. The only idea that's set right now is the Mosasaurus, but we've got mammoths and terrabirds and woolly rhinos and just a bunch of different things. And it doesn't all have to be like this. You know, maybe we'll do like a little pit habitat here and another island over there, something different, like a mountain range. We can just mix it up. Let's go crazy with it, is what I'm saying, basically. Thank you so much for joining me. If you enjoyed this series, enjoyed this episode, I should say, please do hit the like button, leave a comment down below, subscribe to the channel, lots of things for you to do here. And there is a playlist linked in the description if you want to keep up to date with this custom park build. There we go. This is a park build, that was, in case you were curious. Am I done? I'm done. Thank you so much for joining me. I'll see you lovely folks next time. Cheers, much love as always. Bye-bye.